beautiful morning to you and welcome to the news on the hour on Superscreen Television. Blessed Omonose. We're starting off now with the federal government has signed a treaty on mutual legal assistance of criminal matters with Russia. Spokesperson for the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, George Edukpa, will disclose this to journalists in a statement. According to Edukpa, he said the treaty was negotiated in 2009 to enhance collaboration and cooperation between the two countries in the administration of criminal justice. He also noted that the signing of the agreement would assist in the fight against corruption as it makes provision for the tracing, recovery, forfeiture of confiscation of stolen assets, as well as the proceeds and instruments of crimes. The Secretary of the Government of the Federation, SGF Boss Mustafa, affirmed that part of the federal government's efforts to run a government of inclusiveness is the establishment of a policy which will ensure that 5% of vacancies in public service will be ceded to people living with disabilities in the country. Mustafa made this known while speaking at an event held in his office to celebrate the 2018 International Day of Persons Living with Disabilities, which had the theme Empowering Persons with Disabilities and Ensuring Inclusiveness and Equity. Said Nigeria needed to address the needs of every member of the society in an equitable and sustainable manner. He also said that the FG had ensured implementation of the building code to make the design and construction of public buildings friendlier to persons with disability. And in a similar development, persons living with disabilities have called on the federal government to include them in the employment scheme of Nigeria. The group made the call in commemoration of the International Day of Persons Living with Disabilities.
It's a big disgrace back home here in Nigeria that we seem not to recognize people with disability. We look at them as third class even in their own country. If you go to ceremonies, most times you find out that people with disability are being kept behind where they won't be able to see at the front. It saddens my heart because I've been privileged to travel around the world, and most times I'm even working for the International Tennis Federation right on the day of people living with disability, and I know how in other parts of Africa they celebrate people living with disability. It's a big funfair.
I'm not even feeling anything about it. But the reason why, because I noticed that something like this in abroad, people will come to disability people to come and celebrate with us, different company. All the individual people, they are having money, they will come to us and celebrate with us. But in Nigeria here, the reason why I don't like the way they are doing Nigeria here is to come and use us to make money. Trust me, I don't believe that Nigeria government ready to assist anybody in disability. Because we mobilized ourselves about 6 or 7 years ago during the Obasanjo time to Abuja because of our bill. So up to now, they are not ready to do anything about it. They are not even say anything about it.
And away from that now to security matters, the Nigerian Army says it is yet to receive the $1 billion promised by the federal government to fight insurgency in the northeast. Speaking in an interview, Director Army Public Relations Brigadier General Sanin Usman said the Defense Ministry has been working towards receiving the money from the government. Usman said that people should understand also that this is a democratic system in which the procurement and funding of defense-related issues takes such a long time. You will recall that President Muhammadu Buhari in December 2017 promised to take the money from the SS crude account, a decision which became a subject of controversy and debate in the country. And still on the news, the National Assembly has summoned the United States U.S. Ambassador to Nigeria, Stuart Simpton, over the alleged high rate of visa denials of Nigerians. The invitation was said to be at the instance of an activist, Kayode Bello, who petitioned the House over the matter. The summons, entitled incriminate denial of United States of America visa. An illegal increment of exchange rate of visa fee by the American embassy was signed by the House Committee Chairman on Public Petition, Uzo Azuibike. According to the report, many Nigerian students seeking to study in schools were denied visas despite spending a lot of money on different fees. Some of the fees were application fees, evaluation fees, career fees, service fees, visa fees, school fees, which are non-refundable. The two-page document, dated November 27, 2018, stipulated that the hearing would hold on Tuesday, December 4th at 2 p.m. at the House of Representatives, Room 429. The Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, prosecutor in the alleged bribery trial of former Minister of Education, Ibrahim Shekarau, has his foreign affairs counterpart Aminu Wale and Ahmed Mansur has allegedly failed to appear before the Federal High Court before commencement of trial. According to reports, the first defendant, counsel Jibrin Otutekwa, told the court that a letter seeking adjournment received on Monday was served by the prosecutor on November 30, 2018. Otutekwa asked the court to proceed under Section 351, Subsection 1. Of the Administration of Criminal Justice Act to dismiss the 6 counts against the defendants and other their charge. Announced to the ex sector, the Medical Guild, an association of Lagos State Government employed medical and dental doctors, are calling on doctors to take their health issues serious in order to reduce stress and prevent depression. Chairman of the Medical Guild, Saeed Kende, made the call while addressing issues affecting the association.
You finish medical school, no employment. You are doing residency program, you are doing your own money, you have your family, you all your time on the residency. Training, you are not having training. You put all your mind on the treatment of patient. When you put all your mind on the patient, you go home, you meet your own family problem, medical problem, government interference. In the health sector, combine everything together, what now happen? That person will break down. You get home, you get to work, shouting, after seeing patients, shouting, doing everything. You get home, you can't pay the school fees for your child. You can't pay rent. You are not passing exam. What happened? Mental illness. When the project starts this medicine with his sister, who is the nurse, what is her name? Nightingale. What they did to them is that you people just be giving all the service. You are going to, they provide the house for them, they provide food for them, they provide shelter, everything for them. Just keep this. That's why he wrote it. Because he knew that he's not going to suffer, he's not going to be asking for any welfare. What's going to do, treat, and all these things you'll be giving to me. Unfortunately, it's the opposite now.
While commending the state government for its efforts so far, Kende also appealed to government to take a look at the issues of appointment into the state ministry primary healthcare board.
There shall be a commission secretariat which shall be headed by permanent secretary who shall be a medical / healthcare professional in the public health sector with a minimum of 15 years post-qualification experience. Look at the last one, in medical practice and experience in public administration. In medical practice, the simple thing. People that are involved in medical practice are the doctor. When they slack health worker, when they now come to medical practice, that is why when you talk about the issue at the federal level, I went to the court, we go to be CMD. They said medically qualified. In the scheme of service, nurses, everybody have their own, they don't call them, but the only doctor that under the word medical. And when you say medical practice all over the world, are the doctor. Unfortunately, this time around, the better job retired, the governor puts an administrator, Mr. Hashimi, as the permanent secretary of HSC who retired about few weeks ago. He protested. Now again, the same thing happened at the primary healthcare board. Another PS, who is another administrator, Mrs. Ashiku, was employed, which is against the law under the primary healthcare.
And away from that report, we'll take a short break and bring you more in business. Stay with us. Glad to have you back. You're watching Super Screen News at 10. And now to business news. The Nigerian Civil Aviation Authority, in line with the International Civil Aviation Organization's safety standard, says more airports are yet to be certified in 2019 following the certification of Murtala Mohammed International Airport Lagos and the Nnamdi Azikiwe International Airport Abuja. The General Manager, Corporate Communications, Federal Airport Authority of Nigeria, Arietta Yakubu, disclosed this to journalists in Lagos, said at least one airport will be certified next year. She said there are certain conditions that must be met before an airport is certified, adding that before Lagos and Abuja airports were certified last year, they had to fulfill the conditions, and before any other airport to be certified, same conditions too have to be met. Yakubu stressed that the certification of airports improves its safety and other ratings in the global aviation industry. And now to telecoms, the Nigerian telecommunication firm MTN Nigerian and the Attorney General of the Federation case over $2 billion tax demand has been adjourned to February 7, 2019 as the presiding judge, Justice Saliu Sadu, was away on administrative leave. According to reports, the federal High Court in Lagos did not sit on Monday for the hearing of all applications as earlier scheduled due to the absence of the judge. Report says the federal government is yet to file a few reply to its suit, but the company has filed an injunction asking the court to restrain the government from interfering with the business of the company. The telecoms firm is also facing a separate legal battle with the Central Bank of Nigeria, CBN, over allegation that it illegally transferred $8.1 billion from the country in breach of foreign exchange regulations, which will be heard at the Federal High Court today, December the 4th. And now talking climate change, still on business, the World Bank Group has announced plans to double its investments in the fight against climate change to around $2 billion for more than 5 years. World Bank Group President Jim Yong Kim said climate change is an existential threat to the world's poorest and most vulnerable, adding that the new target demonstrates how seriously they are taking the issue. World Bank Chief Executive Christine George Vell also said the funds would be allocated for countries to build better adapted homes, schools and infrastructures, and invest in climate smart agriculture, sustainable water management and responsive social safety nets. The announcement from the World Bank comes just before the opening of the UN Climate Conference in Katowice in Poland. And finally, on business, Central Bank of Nigeria, CBN Governor Godwin Emefiele says Nigerian monthly food imports bill fell from $665.4 million in January 2015 to $160.4 million as of October 2018. Emefiele said the reduction in the food imports were recorded on rice, fish, milk, sugar and wheat, adding that the policy would be maintained. Noting that noticeable declines were steadily recorded in the monthly food import bill from $665.4 million in January 2015 to $160.4 million as at October 2018, a cumulative fall of 75.9% and an implied savings of over $21 billion on food imports alone over that period. According to him, the CBN recently introduced the Real Estate Sector Fund, a facility meant to provide cheap funding at no more than 9% to new projects in the agriculture and manufacturing sectors aimed at boosting output and creating jobs. And away from business, we'll take another short break and bring you more in foreign and sports in a bit. To join us again.